Guys, welcome back. Today we are starting a very important topic, that is parts of speech. Actually, parts of speech plays a very important role in learning grammar, because grammar is based on parts of speech only. Today in this video I am going to introduce the parts of speech and we'll discuss a brief about them, and in coming videos we will discuss all the parts of speech in details and how can we use them. So what are actually the parts of speech? Words are divided into different kinds or classes called parts of speech according to their use or according to the work they do in sentence. The parts of speech are divided in 8 parts, and those parts of speech are noun, verb, pronoun, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction and interjection. Let us try to understand what they do and how can we use them. So the first and the foremost is noun. Noun is a word used as the name of a person, place or a thing, animal, any feeling and idea. So we can say that noun are the words we use to give names. Like Ashok is a nice boy. You can see here that Ashok is a name and hence the noun. And I have used a boy here representing a common noun. Akbar was a great king. You can see that I have underlined the words which are noun. Kolkata is on Hooghly. Both are the names. So nouns are the words that are used as the names. Nouns have also few types and kinds that we will discuss when we will discuss noun in a detailed session. Next part of speech is a pronoun. Pronoun is a word used to replace the noun. Because we cannot use the name every time in the sentence or a paragraph, we use pronouns. You can see here, Preeti is a good dancer. She loves dancing. Here I have used she as a pronoun at the place of Preeti, because Preeti is a name and it is noun. So I have replaced the name by pronoun she. One more example is here. The books are where you left them. Now books are things and noun, and we have used them for books, and them is a pronoun. Coming to the next one, verb. Verb is a word used to express an action or state. Actually, verbs are the most important parts of speech, because there can be no sentence without a verb. You can see examples here. I am writing a book. Now, writing is an action, so I have underlined writing. Next sentence is, I am a teacher. Can you see the verb here? Of course, I have underlined am. Am is not a physical verb but acting as a verb here. Am is actually the present form of verb be. So you can see that there may be not a physical verb, but verb is here. As I already told you that verb is very important, because there can be no sentence without verb. Next part of speech is adjective. An adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun. We can also use adjective to show the characteristic and the quality of something. Like, she is a brave girl. Here, brave is the adjective used for the girl. Girl is a noun here, and we are using any quality, any characteristic that is brave. So, adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun. He is a tall boy. Again, tall is representing something about the noun. So, tall is adjective. There are 20 boys in the class. I have underlined 20 here because 20 is showing number and acting as adjective. Now, coming to the next part of speech, that is adverb. An adverb is a word used to add something to the meaning of a verb, an adjective or another adverb. Please don't get confused between adjective and adverb. Both are quite different. You can see here, he finished the work quickly, and the word quickly is an adverb. This quickly we are using for the verb. Next sentence. This flower is very beautiful. Now you can see that I am using this word very to enhance the beauty of the flower. So, such words are called adverbs. Next part of speech is a preposition. A preposition is a word used with a noun or a pronoun to show how the person or the thing denoted by the noun or pronoun stands in relation to something else. That means preposition can be used to show the relation or the state of something. Like, there is a bird in the garden. You can see that I am talking about bird and I am using in to denote the location of the bird. That means the bird is in the garden now. Next example, see. The girl is fond of music. The of word of is representing the preposition here and it is connecting fond and the girl is fond of music here, right? So, preposition are the words that used for noun or pronoun and show the relation to something. Next part of speech is conjunction. Conjunction is a word used to join words or sentences. Like, two and two make four. Here word and is we are using as conjunction because they are connecting two and two. Next example. I ran fast but missed the train. But is connecting the two sentences like I ran fast and missed the train. So, but is acting as a connector. So, conjunction are the words that used to join the words or sentences. The last part of speech is interjection. Interjection is a word which expresses some sudden feelings. Like, hooray, we won the game. Here, the word hooray is interjection. Like, woho, you are here. You can see this exclamatory sign and can identify the interjection. Some modern grammars include determiners among the part of speech also. Determiners are the words like a, an, the, these, those, each, every, some, any, etc. Actually, the words which determine or limit the meaning of the noun that follow. So, these were the parts of speech and introduction of parts of speech. In the coming session, we will discuss the detailed use of all these parts of speech. Till then, keep watching, keep learning.